Ow! What just bit me? Friggin' biters.
Passing 100 meters. Oxygen efficiency.
Hey guys, welcome back to an episode of Subnautica. Before we end it, I'd like to ask you to please vote and subscribe. Also, leave comments to me down in the comments below. In the description, where there's links to my Twitter, Twitch, and Discord. Twitch for live streams when they happen. Twitter for updates on videos and live streams. And Discord just hang out and chat with me in the community. And now that that's out of the way, let's get into what you actually came to see today, which is us doing some actual Subnautica. This is a little embarrassing, but when I died last time, apparently there's a... You can just get up here and walk around the fire. I didn't know that. I don't know if that's intentional or maybe it's just a glitch. Also, when I came back, I was sucked on one of the bleeder things that you may not have seen. There's definitely some floating around that we'll look at further. Need to repair all these breaches so that we can get
containment breach repaired. Further breaches detected.
Luckily, we have more than enough batteries, and then we just needed to continue. Further breaches detected. I think after we get this taken care of, we head back to base, and I think there'll be a radio message telling us the secret stuff we need to know to get into the room. The code is given to you in a message, which is partially the reason why we don't have it yet. I thought it was something you found on the ship. It's actually not. The message to get into that room is sent to you in like a radio communique. Old oxygen. So yeah.
Containment breach repaired. Further breaches detected.
That would be the plan for this episode. This is the little things I was talking about. Little bastards that suck your blood.
Radiation levels decreasing.
Anything in here? Nothing to scan. Self scan. Don't think it.
Significant levels. No adverse effects detected. Be vigilant for symptoms.
Okay, let's pop out of here, go get that message. Get a depth module for our CMOS, so that's nice. This is also the fun part of this. If it's still the way I remember it. I think I already have this, I just want to double check I didn't forget anything. Okay. Let's get out of here. Let's go in the water. We're going straight this way because I want to get out of range where he can get us. And by he, you know what I mean. Okay, let's go get our message from our life pod. I didn't even notice until I got here. Look at what's happened. I'm holding the controls to the Seamoth, but I also have my Seeklight out somehow. That seems like a glitch. I don't know if it does anything funny or anything like that, but it's definitely a glitch. Oh, that's just a stalker. I was like, is that... thing's louder than that, right? Okay. Well, we survived our quick trip back from... We survived the hard part of our trip back. Oof. Store up some resources. Go get our message. We should put a radio down there, and I think it's like a single piece of titanium, so we will do that in a second, but I first want to get, read through this message.
Layer 3 recorded distress call.
This is Officer Keen in Light Pod 19. The captain is gone. I have assumed command. The last thing the captain did was give me coordinates for dry land. We regroup 1.5 kilometers southwest of the crash site. Stay together and good luck. This message will now repeat.
Rendezvous coordinates corrupted. Transmission origin coordinates downloaded. Signal location uploaded to PDA.
Right. Let's go explore that.
Online.
I mean, we definitely have the depth to handle it. And I'm hoping, since the second officer and the captain is dead, I'm hoping that means that, that the PDA in here will give us the information on how to get into the captain's quarters. Which I think is why I got that message, when I got that message. It's at 300 meters, so it's at our max depth right now. Ow! Fuck, just bit me. Friggin' biters.
Passing 100 meters. Oxygen efficiency decreased.
So bright. In real life, in diving, when they do that, there is literally masks that you wear that are specially designed to handle the brightness because it will blind you. The same as in real life, if you're cutting with a welder or welding, you could cut yourself. Either way, that's lobby. I don't know if I don't know anything about laser cutters. I know you use diamonds in the game to make it. I wonder if that's something that's actually used in making a laser cutter, like maybe as some kind because of their extreme tolerance to things. I know they're using like drill bits and stuff to cut through stuff because of their tolerances. I wonder if the same kind of like, wait, I can buy something. New blueprint acquired. How much titanium? I have so much titanium now because of this. It's very easy to get disoriented. Friggin' fish. I gotta swim in the way. I mean, I know I'm driving around your house, but could you not swim right into my boat? It'd be preferable. There's another piece of wreck. That might give us the power cell charger finally. Yes, it did.
New blueprint acquired.
Gonna be cutting it close. Pardon my pun.
30 seconds.
Thank you. Let's see, these are reinforced statues. I was hoping that was the... I know there's like fins that give you the ability to.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Oh, that's definitely another piece of rag. Ow.
Passing 200 meters. Oxygen efficiency greatly decreased.
The thermal plant.
Biodiversity in this region is unusually low. Cause unknown.
Fire suppression system? No.
Blueprint acquired.
Right. What's over here? I was gonna say, I knew it's in one of these pits nearby.
Signal location uploaded to PDA. Integrating new PDA data.
There you go.
New blueprint acquired. 30 seconds. Integrating new PDA data.
Let's listen to these voice logs.
Detached to K planet 4 in 30 seconds. The computer has identified a landmass at the attached coordinates. I want you to regroup the crew there. Understood, but they are your responsibility now. Don't let them down. Captain, you need to evacuate. Negative. You'll need the ship in one piece if you're going to contact HQ on the long range. I'm attempting a controlled descent.
I'm assuming I know what this dry land mass is, yep. I figured. Okay, high capacity tank plus lithium. We need to get an. Let's work on getting an ultra high capacity tank right now. In a second after I repair the ship. Back to base, there's a new message in at base. And then we'll go from there, see what we're doing next. Like I said, I want to try and get the ultra high capacity tank today. If I can. Because then we're pretty much at maxed our air tank. The only thing we can do to extend our air range at that point is a rebreather. Which, now that we're actually not going to the Aurora anymore, well, no, we still need to go to the Aurora one more time. Once we no longer have to go to the Aurora anymore to do anything, once we've got all the information, which all we're missing is so there's one data log there somewhere that's, it's a data log for, building the Neptune. Once we have that, we won't have to go to the Aurora anymore, and at that point, then we can think about think about getting the rebreather and stuff. It's super cheap to make. It's a wiring kit, which is just 2 silver, and we have a ton of that. And then one more thing I can't think of the name at the moment. We're going to need to get a titanium chest going soon, because we're starting to run out of storage space.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Okay, so we need a circuit. We need wiring kit to make an advanced wiring kit. Just two more gold and a computer chip. We need copper, two gold. I forgot what a computer chip requires. I think it's like table coral and something else. Table core gold and the copper wire, so we need that stuff. There should be table core right here. Nope, it's up here. Definitely enough stuff. Get it as close as we can without the two titanium, and then we'll go grab our two titanium. All right, power cell charger if we need it. Ultra high capacity tank. And now we have how much oxygen left? 225, okay. We're at pretty much, like I said, max. Oil. Good to have some of it though. And then we need a battery change on all of our items. Oh, and then there was a message, but we wanted to build a relay inside.
Sunbeam? You know Aurora. We're from a little transgov on the far side of Andromeda, and we have a saying there. There's no bad without the good, no good without the bad. Sounds like you tasted a bunch of the former, but that only means you're overdue a whole lot of the latter. Might just be we're in. We're scanning for somewhere to park. We'll be in touch when we find it. Sunbeam out.
That's good. We find it sooner rather than later. Okay. So, pretty much out of time. Got a lot of stuff done this time. I hope you all enjoyed it. Let me turn off our beacon and our beacon. Hope you all enjoyed the episode. And have a good day, guys. Goodbye.